WCR FM. Call us now on 01900 734 669.
You're listening to the Paul and Ronnie Show. We're joined this evening by Paul Sherwin, manager of the Carnegie Theatre and Munro's Bar in Workington. Probably best known in that role, Paul, but maybe not a lot of people appreciate that there was, you know, considerable life before the Carnegie, and you'd been in into music and playing in local bands, you know, for some considerable time before that. Myself, you know, I guess I kind of got into music, like music, from being about 8 or 9, but I didn't want to be in a band until punk rock came along. I thought, well, I'm going to do that with my mates. Did you ever, what inspired you?
Well, the first band that I ever saw was a band called the Electrons.
Electrons,
popular Workington band.
Yeah.
And I guess that was in sort of 1963.
Yeah.
I'll be about 11.
Yeah.
Something like that. At Harrington Methodist Church School Rooms.
Yeah.
And they were playing a gig there. And people who were in the band, the Electrons, yeah, people like Jeep Jones and Dave Needham and Billy Reese and Tiny Holmes.
Yeah, they all must have been quite young. Come on now, no, quite young.
quite young at the time.
18, 19, yeah?
Yeah, but the Electrons were a very popular band in Workington. They weren't the most popular. The most popular band were the Invaders from Whitehaven,
yeah,
who came around about 1964, 65. Yeah. And the Invaders were really a long way ahead of their time.
Yeah.
But I like the idea of joining a band, and yeah, I wanted to sort of drive around in Bedford Dormobiles and Thames Traders and all those, yeah, sort of wacky things that, yeah, bands do at the time.
Yeah.
So I decided I would be in a band,
and
about a year or a year and a half later, I was in a band,
mm-hmm,
playing bass guitar.
And that band was it was a school band. What was it called again?
It became AC Experiment.
Yeah.
And we played all over the place, all over Cumbria, anyway.
Yeah.
But I think I would be about 14 at the time.
Yeah.
And
how much were you getting paid for the gig then?
Well, it was about £10 a night, something like that. But I also, when I was 15, started to promote dances.
Yeah.
We used to promote dances at places like Lauka and Parton.
Mm.
And these were dances that started at midnight.
Funny place to go dancing, isn't it?
Well, people did,
yeah,
in the sort of villages,
yeah,
and it was bank holiday weekends, and it started at midnight and went on till 4 o'clock in the morning. Now, you couldn't dance on a Sunday,
yeah,
so it was Sunday night.
I can't dance on any day.
Yeah, we noticed. But it was Sunday night, but it started at about a minute past midnight, which actually made it Monday morning.
Yeah.
And they held them at bank holiday weekends.
Yeah.
And that's where we started promoting dances,
yeah,
and charging sort of 2 and 6 to get in, and,
yeah,
and having 200 or 300 people in there.
Yeah.
And I think we soon found that you actually made more money promoting dances than actually playing in.
So you were getting a tenner for playing, well, a fourth share of it, £2.15.
Yeah, and then all the profits from...
£2.10.
Yeah, and then all the profits from running it. And, of course, before we went to every gig that we were promoting, went down, yeah, to Brothwell and Mills.
Yeah.
You remember them?
Yeah,
and,
the pop place, yeah.
Yeah, bought loads and loads of sort of crates of Vimto,
yeah,
on sale the return, and cheesy crisps.
Yeah.
And they went in the van as well. So we were getting paid for playing in the band.
Yeah.
We were taking the profits from promoting the gig.
Yeah.
And then we were getting the catering and the Vimto as well.
Fantastic. So it was very lucrative.
So, yeah, it was very good fun as well, and very enjoyable. And obviously, people were turning out and being very happy about it all.
Very good. Well, Ashley Kay's Invaders, they're from Whitehaven. Did they concentrate on playing locally as well? Because you're saying that, you know, in terms of local bands in the 60s, they were found a way of the best, were they?
Yes, they were. And they were technically very competent. And they went and played in places like Yorkshire, which in sort of 1966 was a bit unheard of because the roads were awful around, yeah, Cumbria and out of Cumbria into York. I mean, they're just country lanes, really.
Yeah.
And they used to travel quite a long distance. And
for more than a tenner, I presume.
Oh, yes. Ashley Kay's Invaders were earning £25 to £30 a night between, mm, them in 1966, which was probably, you know, well, it was an awful lot of money. It was it was more than somebody's weekly wage in those days. But they were tremendously popular, and they were worth every penny because they were good. I was a bit surprised that they never actually made it, but they certainly had the talent and the capability. And recently, they've sort of reformed.
Yeah,
and
I think I remember seeing a post. It might have been some like 60s gala charity night or something in somewhere, or in Civic Hall somewhere. Where, is that right?
It was, and so they've reformed to do a few charity gigs. I hope to get them sometime at Monroe's in Workington, and I just hope they're as good as I remember they were.
Yeah.
And I think we'll have a great night. But they were big
news. Do you think you could get them for £35?
I'll try them for 45, but right. I have an idea. They might push me a little higher, but
50?
No, not 50.
If anybody can get them for £35, Paul, it's you, I'm sure.
Well, I'll do my best. But if they're as good as they used to be,
yeah.
it could be an awesome night.
Okay. We're going to play your next record now. It's Barry White, who I've got to say is one of my all-time favourite people. Yeah, but I think this has got particular memories for you. Do you want to tell us what it is before we shove it on?
Well, it is, because I went off to Australia. I got a gig in Australia in a town called Newcastle, which is sort of north of Sydney.
Yeah.
So I was out there for about 18 months in a nightclub out there, which was absolutely great. And I first heard Barry White.
You were liking the Houseman, didn't you?
Yes, that's right. And it was fun because it was hot and sunny and the beaches were great.
Yep.
And I was driving through Sydney at about 5 o'clock in the morning.
Yeah.
One morning.
Yeah.
Through the skyscrapers of Sydney.
Yeah.
And Barry White came on the radio, and I heard him for the first time. And it was just that the music sort of suited the place and the time and everything else that
Went
along with it.
Working on a wet Wednesday night in February maybe doesn't have quite the same ambience, but he's fantastic nonetheless. Here's Big Barry.
We got it together, didn't we? We've definitely got our thing together, don't we, baby? Isn't that nice? I mean, really, when you really sit and think about it, isn't it really, really nice? I can easily feel myself slipping and slipping more and more away into that super world of my own. Nobody but you and me. We've got it together, baby. Could have made two. You're all I'm living for. Your love I'll keep forevermore. You're the first, you're the last, my everything. Oh,